First video, we'll have a look at the board, what the various symbols mean on them. Notice they're these little triangles like that. They are the battle stations, which is a form of base. It's not the lowest form of base. There is a mobile base as well, which can be upgraded to a battle station, and then from a battle station you go upwards to these, which are star bases. We've got minor planets, these little green ones here, the big green ones, if I can just find one over here, is a major planet. We have home planets, which are actually indicated by the insignia of the nation. Oh, Lily, get off the table. That little cat arrived. We've got the various national areas, which are like blue's the Federation. You see these little yellow lines around it, these are provinces, all of which contribute to your economic power. You have these little, this is really weird the way the camera's coming here. You see where these lines here, these are actually grey, and these are dark grey. It's actually appearing as almost white and light grey. But those grey things between the black boundaries are the neutral zones between the various national groups. We have, as I said, the Federation, we have the Romulan Space Empire, we have the Gorns, we've got the Interstellar Confederacy, which we won't get involved with at the moment. Got the Tholians down the bottom here. We have the Klingons, we have the Kints up there, the Reds, the Lyrans in yellow, and the Hydrans in green here. There's a few oddballs floating around like that. That unit there in the darker orange is a Lyran Democratic Republic, I think. I'm not sure exactly. We've got the Orion Space Pirates. That's it for national groups. I'm not sure why this area of Romulan space is actually in a different colour. No idea. Right, so let's look at the counters. Whoops, stop. Sorry about that. Right, counters, pretty basic because these are done from a long time ago. You got your class of ship right at the top and the right. You've got an actual silhouette making, which represents the sort of national sort of shape. Each thing, each sort of nation has different sort of silhouettes for their ships. If you've got a number right in the top left there, that's the number of ships. You see there are actually three ships shown there. So that's not one single vessel, that's three. Your combat effectors, you've got attack and defense. Now, if they're different, you'll have two numbers there. If they're not, if they're the same, you're just going to have a single number there. In the middle left here, lots of units carry fighter components, and that's your number of fighters. Your little symbol here, the diamond, in this case indicates the number, indicates whether it's a scout or not. There's loads of different things here. You don't see these that often, but you can, there's loads of them, as you can see, whether it's a carrier escort, a maul, carries a super heavy mauler weapon, fighter factors, I've already mentioned, scout capability. So there's quite a few little bits and bobs there that could be used for certain rarer types of unit. Let's have a quick look at a like the Kints, their fleet chart at the moment. Is what you see, these little counters here, these represent fleets, and the fleets are on the actual fleet chart here, because basically there's no stacking limit in this game. You can have infinite number of ships in a hex, because they represent each hex represents a huge area of space, to such a degree that a battle station and star base, its weapons don't actually reach across the entire hex, so you cannot actually attack without being affected by the base's weapons. And that's a bit of an aside there. So we look at this lot here, what we've got. You can see MB, that's a mobile base. Mobile bases have to be moved by tugs. So that TGC is a tug unit. We've got cruisers, escort carrier in the middle, that's CVE. FRD is a fleet repair depot. That's a, like a mobile depot that can, it can move one hex on its own, but if it can be moved by a tug. So tugs have a movement rate of six, but they're actually transporting anything with them. It costs them two movement points to enter each hex. We've got some frigates there, FF. You'd normally have a flagship associated with these. Now there's a dreadnought down here, which is a big ship here. That would be your flagship for this particular fleet. It's important that when because big ships have what's called a command capability, and that's the number of ships they can command in battle. So even though you've got a stack in a hex which may be gigantic like that, only a certain number of units can fight effectively in the battle, and that's governed by your command capability. I don't think there's anything else particularly interesting about these. You got some EFF, got a carrier escort symbol on them. DF unit there with its number inside brackets, well, means it carries drone weapons, so it can bombard using drones. I can't see anything particularly interesting about the rest of the King's fleet. Fleets have what they call these reserve markers, which allow you to move in the reserve movement phase of an enemy's turn. You've got repair units, which are used, they're deployed by strategic movement, and it's allow you to repair vessels. You should have some counters for your battle stations and your star bases. There's usually a battle station on one side and a star base on the other side. You also got convoys, which I'm not really sure what they're used for. So that's a pretty good range of what sort of units you'll see in a fleet. There's obviously quite a few more that we haven't come across, but I won't get into that now.